Hi everyone, thank you for watching another episode of Xbox gameplay videos. My name's Daniel and I'm following on from my two videos earlier for Resident Evil Village on the Xbox Series S. So today, now I'll be testing the Series X with ray tracing and without. With the Series X version, resolution is at 4K and 60 FPS without ray tracing, and with ray tracing, the official stats are 4K and it's 45 FPS. However, I have played it and it does seem to be higher than that stated 45 FPS with ray tracing. So that's interesting that it's given as 45 FPS officially, but it seems to be unlocked. So I'm going to be testing the game with ray tracing again. I'll be going through the same stage that I did first time round with the on the Series S, because I don't want to ruin the game for you. But also it allows me to sort of remember what I'm looking for when it comes to the ray tracing, because with the Series S I was in two minds on whether I did notice any differences, and now I'm going to be looking out for where I thought I did notice the differences, and then it's something I'll be able to confirm. But it must be noted I'm playing on a 1080p TV at the moment. So whether it's very clear, I'm not sure. So it could make a difference, more of a difference, if you're using a 4K TV playing it, you know, the way it's meant to be. So just quickly going into the hard drive. So it's the same as the S version, 30.2 gig. So I'll jump into the game now, and I hope you enjoy. Please like if you do. Please subscribe, because there's going to be many more games I'll be uploading for Series S and X. If you have any requests, you know, please comment as well. Any feedback's much appreciated as well, so enjoy.
Long ago, a young girl went with her mother to pick berries for her father, who was hard at work. But the forest greeted them with a dark, cold silence, the bushes empty. Yet determined to find the berries, the Rasko broke free from mother's grasp and vanished into the trees. Mother's worried cries faded fast as the girl ran on, over vine and under branch, and into the forest deep. Feeling strange eyes upon her, the girl recalled mother's scary bedtime tales, and her throat became bone dry. Then the Bat Lord appeared. He greeted her warmly and bit his own wing. "Come, child, quench your thirst," he said. So she drank the thick, dark blood and smiled with joy. Passing through the graveyard, menacing storm clouds loomed, and the air turned bitingly cold. The girl was shivering in her thin clothes. Then a dark weaver appeared, and with a click of his fingers, crafted mist into a beautiful dress. "Come, child, warm yourself," he coaxed. So she clothed herself and smiled with joy. Across waters deep and ominous she went. hoping a boat she found would carry her home. But hunger's grip tightened and her heart grew heavy. Then the Fish King appeared and offered one of his many fins. Come, child, eat your fill. So the girl ate and smiled with joy once more. Continuing on, she soon entered the forest's dark heart. Then an iron steed appeared, bearing a beautiful golden gear. The creature said nothing as the girl approached and snatched what she thought was another gift. The horse grew angry and summoned the other monsters. Terror filled the girl's heart as a wild wind rose around the beasts. Suddenly, a witch appeared, dark, yet regal. Gifts we gave, but more you took, she snarled. So more in turn is due. In a blink, the girl was trapped inside a mirror. There. She's asleep.
What is with the creepy story? She's only 6 months old.
Woman at the store said it was traditional. A local tale. Besides, Rose doesn't seem to mind.
Because she doesn't understand it, thank God. We moved here so that she wouldn't have to deal with any of that, remember?
There's nothing wrong with my memory. You're just being paranoid.
It's not... Never mind. I'm sorry. But I'm not paranoid. I'm just cautious.
Then, go cautiously take your daughter to bed. I'll finish dinner.
It's okay, Rose. Your mother doesn't want to remember. I can't blame her.
Did you say something?
Nothing. I'll put her down.
Once you're a big girl, we'll have a drink together, all right?
Mia makes everything by hand, so this stuff keeps piling up.
There. It's like I said to your mom. That book's too scary for you. Gotta do a deep clean before Rose starts walking around. Everyone's forgotten about this already. Almost there, honey. Thank you.
go, sweetheart. Don't you worry. I'll be right downstairs. Daddy won't let those weird fairy tale monsters get you.
Is she okay?
Sleeping like a baby. That smells good. What's that?
Oh, hands off, mister. It's churba de lagum. It's a local recipe.
Wow, you've gone full native, haven't you?
Local wine, too. But if you're gonna keep sulking all evening, maybe you shouldn't have any. You really have to stop worrying.
It's just... finding you in Louisiana, the pregnancy, Chris moving us here, military training, it all happened so fast, you know?
Well, at least we're all together. You, me, Rose. Now, everything's gonna
Seriously, think we can just forget about what happened in Louisiana?
It happened so long ago. I don't understand why you are so...
Mia, get down! Mia! Mia, oh God! Chris? What the hell?
Sorry, Ethan.
What? Why?
Go move.
All clear.
Rose?
What the hell are you doing with my daughter?
Package secure, sir.
Take him away.
I said, get your hands off her!
Ethan, no.
Rose.
Get him out here.
Hey, Doc.
Hello, Mr. Winters. I've got your daughter's results back, and I'd like you to come in to talk about them. How about next Thursday, 4 o'clock?
No problem. We'll be there. That was the doc. She'll see us next week.
Hey, now. Think positively, all right? We talked about this.
I know. We hardly talk about anything else. Keep telling you, it's not Rose that I'm worried about.
Well, then what are you worried about? Look, she's gonna be fine. I just know it. What else matters?
We matter, Ethan! You matter! You just won't.
Mia, what are you talking about? Is there something you're not telling me? Come on, talk to me.
Damn it. I have to take this.
Jesus.
About damn time. What are you talking about? Where's Chris Redfield? And Rose?
Who is this? This is a secure channel. You are not on my level.
Fuck. What the hell happened here? Thank you. did all this. Hell am I? Maybe they're out. What happened?
Friendly.
Who are you? Who sent you?
Nobody. There was an accident down on the road and...
Shh.
What's going on? Oh, no. They're coming. Who is? What the hell was that?
Do you have a gun?
What?
Please tell me you have a gun.
No, why would I?
Take it! Take it!
Help us out there. Hey, are you listening? Dead body? Wait, there's more. Jesus Christ. What the hell is wrong with this place? What the fuck was that? Is it over?
Hello. If there are any survivors out there, come to my... to Louisa's house near the fields.
Survivors? There's no end to them. Wait.
And in death, we give glory.
Hello? You shouldn't be out here. It's not safe. What the hell? Hey, can you hear me?
It's you, the child's father.
Child? Hey, wait, do you mean Rose? Is she here?
Rose! Rose, yes. She is in great danger. Since Mother Miranda brought her to the village, we have fallen into darkness.
What are you talking about? The monsters?
The castle bell heralds danger. They're coming!
No. Wait. Where's Rose? Who's Mother Miranda?
The bell tolls for us all. They're coming again!
Rose is here?
So that's my gameplay for Xbox Series X with ray tracing for my part 2 where I play without the ray tracing. I'm just going to continue from where I am because from comparing where I thought I saw differences when I was playing the Series S version without ray tracing and I was playing this one and I was looking out and I knew what I was looking out for, I didn't notice any difference. I really didn't. So obviously the frame rate is better for the X version with the ray tracing, but there are drops in the frame rates. So I'm expecting that the version without ray tracing will be pretty much locked on 60 FPS and probably the one to play on. I should add again that I'm not playing on a 4K TV, so that could make the difference. If you see the differences in the where you use ray tracing and you don't. But like I said, I haven't noticed anything. But then I'm just using 1080p TV, so I will jump into the next game now without the ray tracing. I'm going to continue from where I am because there's no point starting from the beginning again. And then at some point I think I'll do an extended play as well, just play the game as normal. This is my first Resident Evil I've played since Resident Evil 5, which was good, but I didn't really like in the sense that you couldn't shoot and walk at the same time. I have played Resident Evil 1 and 2 when that was first out on the PlayStation, on the original PlayStation, which I had from my teen days, and they were fantastic games. So it's interesting to see how the game has evolved to a first person perspective now, and I think it kind of probably makes it a bit more immersive in the horror, but you know the originals were great, and I think the first person is probably better suited than playing the game as a third person view, purely for the fact that it's much more immersive and it looks like you are seeing it from your own eyes. So I will play the version now without the ray tracing and I hope you enjoyed this video, and please subscribe if you want to see many more videos for Xbox Series S and X. Thank you.